You seem torn between the others.
oven because I use the bedroom.
Thank you.
even about me, and I feel like I'm like, oh,
you seem torn between the idea of getting together big band, in which you can step back, and a smaller unit, a kind of rock and roll thing, where you can project your own musical thing. Is that a real problem for you?
I don't know, I think about the rock and roll thing so much as, well, everybody goes to that, so I'm thinking about those friends. So they might want to get back, you know, together. So. Something similar to that, it would probably even a better beat and, you know, more music.
Would it be practical for you if you had an organist and a vocalist so that you could step back as a guitarist?
Well, that's exactly what I want to do, actually. That's what I want to do. All I do is, like, try to get two
just as an example of the extreme limitations of pixel art, our character, the Drifter, is somewhere around 32 pixels high, maybe even less, somewhere in this 16-24. I should know this by now anymore. That's really tiny. and we are designing some wildlife for one of the scenes, and I was drawing these little squirrels. And so if you only have 16 spaces to make a full-size POV, to make a squirrel, you're working with like a 3x4 with that. And then how it sent those off all the years.
Thank you. your knees.
You know, they always have the spacemen, you know, like a Hollywood studio.
When I was at Fox, it was really like that. It was just stuff.
You're supposed to scream. There's like the pictures they took.
It froze because of you.
It comes from the independent people.
Thank you. kidding.
Shift around.
Look at the fun we're having. Saruman also starts out being sent to Earth to be a force for good. And in the end, he too is corrupted. We see him mostly functioning as a villain, so well, put the Saruman
skin was that way anyway.
Obviously, some ability to Saruman. Yes, that will bring you more
Thank you.
In July, he was charged with weapons and marijuana possession. Yet, he kept his
mouth shut. And she really wanted to talk about kind of the mythology of celebrity. And so, kind of digging in. When we think we know the world so well, we don't know what's going on.
Appreciation or acceptance, or you don't need to be a household name in Germany or something.
It's like a secret society.
Anyone fitting into the fit in, it didn't matter if you were 40 or 16, if you were a runaway or a draft artist or a woman or a man or whatever. Nothing bad except that if you knew you belonged there, then everyone else knew you belonged there. So it was, to me, it's like a pinnacle of cultural and social activity, is to have a scene like that that's just driven by ideals.
The music was a currency. It was just what we were trading, what everyone had in common. But the actual scene itself was what was an exchange of all the individuals who were part of that, of this like kind of clique, or this kind of small cell of people that kind of identified with the music and currency. The kids, for the first time, writing their own songs, forming their own bands, putting on their own shows, putting out their own records, putting out their own magazines. There was kids doing that, and it was outside of the industry. It was true rock and roll, underground, without state or government or corporate sponsorship. It was just done on the energy of these kids alone.
Something really amazing and vibrant can come from anywhere, regardless of what the talent is, regardless of how old the musicians are, regardless of what it cost them to make the record.
You know, this mainstream convention, it's like, yo, go up, damn, this guy's like, you can do anything you want. It's just, and you can take it or leave it. About punk rock.
Artists decided to take control over their own culture. Okay, they were going to put their own magazines, they're going to put out their own records, they were going to come up with their own graphic sensibility, and they weren't going to borrow a bunch of money to hire an attorney to lobby for some kind of major label record contract. Okay, they were just interested in creating art.
We can best express what we want our records to look like, so we'll design the record cover. Instead of being on the phone to somebody who is lining up the engagements, well, we'll call the people up and make the engagement arrangements ourselves.
It was a completely organic sort of rogue operation, but one that was solid.
Especially when you're a teenager, if you find something that you think is the greatest thing in the world, what teenager is quiet? There are none. So. You start a fancy. You get a radio show. That's what I did. You talk to all of your friends, and you make sure that the word is out that there's something really wonderful, and that will always be the case.
When you're young and you know you're part of the underground, what's exciting to you is knowing about things that nobody else knows about.
It made me feel like I was very special, and I was onto something that nobody else was onto. And then remember, this is like all pre-internet, pre-cell phone, pre-any of that, so pre-MTV. A lot of the information about this music could only be obtained by writing a letter to somebody for a copy of the zine, because they only printed 500 copies, or driving a couple of hours to the big city to go to one store that might have one copy of the zine. You really had to work to track down this information.
We didn't really know what was happening in America. We didn't have the structure in America at that time to teach people about it. There was no real organized independent distribution network. There were no real independent labels.
It was all about the infrastructure. The U.S. was really lagging far behind in that department. But I felt that through the touring network that bands like Black Flag really helped to establish, the zine scene and the actual record labels were giving support to bands, we started to generate some attention.
The industry kind of got hit to what was it seemed underground. That's when the world started up to be more fun.
I think the star of that was R.E.M., which was considered as kind of experimental. They didn't fit the mold of the traditional rock industry, but they became.
Let me check this sound lab first.
Because I'm trying to talk to you, you keep walking right there. garbage.
Hit that! Eat a bunker!
Run it!
Break down! Hey, DJ!
Yes?
What a load of garbage.
Hit that! Eat a bunker!
Run it!
Break down! Hey, DJ!
Yes?
Hidden ropes.
Keep your wrist relaxed and bump the sticks off the drum head. Can you feel how this rebound action makes it easier to play? Okay, now let's play the drums a bit to learn your way around the stage.
Century that had been in existence. There were small innovations along the way, but it was still basically people were making these movies the same way they were when Georges Méliès was sending rockets to the moon. And I felt like we at Leica had the opportunity to tell different types of stories using different techniques so they could be visually distinctive, but also tap into something that was really emotional, something that was thought-provoking, to tell stories that were bold and distinctive and enduring. And that really was something that I felt was missing in animation at the time.
We shoot on ones, which means for every frame, we move the puppet. Whereas most places will shoot on tubes. So they're essentially animating 12 frames a second. So every time they move the puppet, they take two pictures. And it looks nice, but the subtlety and the nuance and smoothness you can get shooting on ones is a whole another level. And it's beautiful. It pushes the medium to places that it's never been. You see these puppets come to life in ways that you believe they're alive. They're not puppets or dolls anymore. And that's pretty special. And I think that's what sets us apart.
Just through the things that we learned and the exploring of techniques and materials on Coraline, I think it sort of become a bit of a hallmark then for Leica films moving forward that our characters would have.
Was in its infancy, mainly used by
department that builds, animates, and pre-prints all of the facial performances for like top.
But as fate would have it, Norman's supernatural power just ended with the bottom thing standing between his back and the impending wrath of an ancient curse.
Thank you for visiting the museum. I wonder if you can just not push this.